Please welcome Taz Harai.
Good morning, everybody, and thank you for joining us for the 2003 E3 PlayStation press conference. Last year since E3, the 1 year that's passed, has been a very exciting year for us, and this year promises to be more exciting. And we have a lot of ground to cover today with you, a lot of exciting information that we're very excited to share with you, a lot of new information on the PlayStation business, and we're taking the PlayStation business. And so I hope that you will share all the information with everybody, and hope you find the press conference to be very informative. So I'm going to jump right in. We all know that the video game industry is an industry in transition. In the 1880s, saw the start of the recorded music industry when Edison first invented the phonograph record. In the 1920s, saw the start of the motion picture industry, the movie business as we know it today. In the 1950s, television came of age. And of course, in 1975, a very important year for our industry, the video game business started with the original Pong. 20 years after the original Pong was launched, we in North America launched the original PlayStation, and in 1998, we were able to take the PlayStation and really penetrate it into the mass market. And of course, in 2000, we again revolutionized the industry by launching the PlayStation 2 in North America, Japan, and also in other territories. I'm going to take a very brief moment to explain and share with you some of the latest numbers on where we are with the PlayStation business. And on the PS1, on a worldwide basis, we are now over 96 million units. So we're really closing in on that magic 100 millionth PlayStation. Not to be outdone, the PS2, over 51 million units now worldwide. Still, the installed base is accelerating at about 2.5 to 3 times that of the installed base pickup of the original PlayStation. Taking a look at software, that's where all the business is really coming from. As we all know, content is king. 917 million PlayStation software units worldwide, and for the PS2, 350 million. And we expect that another 250 million PlayStation and PlayStation 2 titles will be coming out into the market this year. Just taking a quick look at the competitive tie ratios, as you can see, life to date, PlayStation 2 has 6.5 to 1 tie ratio, the PlayStation at 10.3. This year, calendar year to date, PlayStation has topped the 10 to 1 tie ratio at 11.1 to 1, and on the PlayStation, we're looking at 18.6 to 1. Very impressive numbers indeed. Again, this business is all about content. And this is where we excel again. On the PlayStation 2, just in North America, we expect to have, by the end of the year, more than 580 titles in the PlayStation family. As I stood here last year, I talked about the fact that the console war was over. And boy, was it ever over. 51.2 million units worldwide, and I have the numbers up there for the other two platforms. I'd like to take paraphrase a TV commercial that I recently saw. There's a place where you can find the other video game consoles, and that happens to be in the rear view mirror. Now, winning the console wars is great, but it's incumbent upon us to make sure that we further evolve the business beyond the traditional battle of the boxes. We need to depart from the status quo, and leadership requires new thinking. So, don't just look to PlayStation and Sony for just leadership in the game space. Really, look to us for finding the right path to entertainment convergence. How do we do that? We're taking a three-pronged approach. Leadership, reflecting, understanding what the consumers want from us, and continuously evolving the PlayStation 2 platform. In the first step, as we embark on this new strategy, we wanted to share with you today four of the most important aspects of our strategy: content, hardware evolution, community, and market expansion. So first, let me touch upon content. PlayStation breeds the hits. This is just an example of some of the great titles that have come to the market on the PlayStation 2 by our third-party publishing partners. A brief example of the million-unit sellers that have come on the PlayStation 2 format from our third-party partners. And, of course, exclusive content is always very important to drive the platform and the PlayStation 2 install base. And to this end, I'm happy to announce today that Solid Snake is going to be back only on PS2. Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater, when it comes out next year, will be available only on the PlayStation 2. Thank you. Another great franchise, Grand Theft Auto. Rockstar continues to innovate the category with the breakthrough products that they bring. Grand Theft Auto redefined really what gaming is all about. Grand Theft Auto Vice City covered new ground, and it was released accompanied by a soundtrack album as well. And this franchise has sold more than 17 million units now combined worldwide. And to this end, I'm happy to announce again that Grand Theft Auto, the next installment of the series, will debut exclusively on the PlayStation 2. Not to be outdone, we've worked hard to bring innovative, envelope-pushing, exciting titles from our first-party studios, and this is an example of some of the million sellers that we've had from our first-party studios: Jak and Daxter, Ratchet and Clank, The Getaway from our European company, Sony Computer Entertainment Europe, SOCOM US Navy SEALs, 1.2 million units, and this has only been released thus far in the North American market only. So we've yet to see sales in Japan, Europe, and some of the other territories. And from our studios in Japan, Hot Shots Golf. Today, I'm also very excited to share with you an entirely new franchise that we will be bringing to the PlayStation 2, developed out of our Foster City studios, called Rise to Honor. This game has been inspired by the action films from Hong Kong and features the international action star Jet Li. He has been an integral part of the development process, helping us with the choreography, helping us coming in to do the motion capture on the game. And this features a very exciting 360-degree martial arts fighting system where you can battle with multiple enemies at the same time. I have a video to share with you on Rise to Honor, so let's take a quick look at that.
Here we are early in the year 2000, and we're putting together a game that's based on Hong Kong action movies. Jet Li calls up Sony and says, "Hey, I'd like to be in a video game."
We know how to make an action movement in a movie, because you have a character, you have a bad guy, they have, you know, table, chair, you have location, situation.
If you've seen any sort of a group fight scene with Jet, he's got guys flying at him from every different angle. We really wanted to have a 360-degree fight system.
When I played a lot of games, all the actions were so simple. But for this project, we're using motion capture to give the characters more realistic motion.
It's a good opportunity to work with Sony PlayStation, because the game, like a movie, is teamwork.
Rise to Honor, ladies and gentlemen. And now let me talk about the killer app on the PlayStation, and certainly for the PlayStation 2, none other than Gran Turismo. More than 32 million units of the franchise product is sold worldwide on the PlayStation and the PlayStation 2. It is by far the most successful franchise in our company's history. Gran Turismo 3 A-Spec, which was the latest title launch for the PlayStation, has sold now over 11 million units worldwide. What I'd like to do now is to show you a brief clip that kind of goes through the history of the Gran Turismo franchise and share with you where we have come up until today. So let's take a look at that video. And now I'd like to introduce our first special guest to talk to you more about how we intend to evolve the Gran Turismo franchise. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce the producer of the Gran Turismo series and the president of Polyphony Digital, Mr. Kazunori Yamauchi.
Thank you for sharing your time with me today. I'm very happy to be able to stand in front of you all to introduce our new title, Gran Turismo 4.
前作グランツリスモ3というのはですね、僕らにとって、ある意味非常に悩まずに作れたタイトルだったんですね。
When I recall the development of the previous title, Gran Turismo 3, I remember not having to worry much. This was because GT3 was the first version of Gran Turismo to run on the then brand new PlayStation 2 computer entertainment system. But this time, it doesn't work that way. GT4 is the second Gran Turismo game to be released on the PlayStation 2 platform.
私たちはですね、過去2年間、グランツーリスモ4で我々がなすべきことは何か、車とは何だろう、 車がいる場所、環境とは何だろう、もっと言うとですね、車がいるこの地球って何だろうということをですね、深く深く考え続けてきました。そして何よりですね、一番考えていたのは、プレイステーション2でできることというのはまだまだあるだろうと、それは何なのかということを考え続けてきたわけです。
For the past 2 years, we've continued to think very hard on our goals and objectives for GT4. We have traveled all over the world to see and explore many different cars as possible, and to better understand what meaning cars have in our lives, in our living environment, and furthermore, on this earth. Our goal was to explore and maximize the unexplored performance of the PlayStation 2.
これからお見せするビデオにはですね、2つのコンテンツが含まれています。1つはですね、我々がグランツリスモ4に向けて全世界で行ってきた 取材の模様、あともう一つはですね、今現在も東京のポリフォニーのですね、研究室で行われているグランツリスモ4のための新しいプレイステーション2のテクノロジーの映像、この2つが含まれています。ご覧ください。The
video we are about to show you includes footage of visits we have made to various locations around the world, and also some of the new technology of PlayStation 2 developed at Polyphony Studios. Please have a look. Scream and shout, lift my hands. Scream and shout, lift my hands.
feel the magic, hearing voices in the wind. Rhythm deep inside my soul, reminiscing the places I've been. All the good times in my life, city lights and sleepless nights. Charges in the atmosphere. If I just close my eyes, fantasies revealed, oh so clear. Painted ladies with a room with attitude. As the DJ sets the mood. Lost in the rhythm, outside it's a brand new day. Makes all my troubles seem so far away.
プレイステーション2の能力にはですね、まだまだ終わりがない、そう思います。それではですね、グランツリスモ4のスペックについて簡単に触れたいと思います。
I hope I was successful in showing you how Gran Turismo 4 has improved and in giving you to a certain extent a sense of significance behind such improvements. You might have felt that there are still so many things that can be done on the PlayStation 2, and I share the same feelings with you. Now, let me take time to lightly touch upon some of the planned key features.
まずですね、グランツリスモにとって一番大事な、自動車のシミュレーションエンジンについてなんですけれども、これはですね、1997年のですね、グランツリスモ開闢以来のですね、初めての大掛かりな、メジャーアップデートを行います。
For the first time since the introduction of Gran Turismo in 1997,The car physics simulation engine will also see a major upgrade.
このエンジンはですね、自動車産業における、ラップタイムシミュレーションにも使えるぐらい、非常に高い精度を持っておりまして、その精度ゆえにですね、今まで以上に、車のドライビングというものがですね、リアルに体験できるということです。あと、リアルになるのと同時にですね、初心者にとっても大変乗りやすいものになる、そういう進化を遂げています。
In the lap time simulation in GT4, high levels of accuracy satisfying the actual automobile makers is achieved, while driving will also be improved.
それからですね、適車の振る舞いを決定づける、AI ですね、適車の AI に関しても、今回ですね、グランツーリスモのシリーズ始まって以来の大掛かりな、アップグレードを行うつもりでおります。まあ、これは具体的にどうなるかというとですね、適車の振る舞いが、もっともっとスムーズに、もっともっと人間らしくなるということです。
Also, a major upgrade will be made for the AI. This is also for the first time in the series. The competition will feel more human rather than computer controlled.
収録する車についてです。車の、数についてはですね、現在我々過去に我々が作ってきたどの作品よりも多く、収録したい、そう思ってます。まあ、我々のコンセプトとしては、車が、誕生してからですね、現在までの車の歴史というものをですね、もう一回グランツーリスモでしかできない文脈で読み直してみようと、そういうものです。
At this time, I'm intending to have more cars in Gran Turismo 4than any other games in the past. The concept of this game is to re-experience the history of cars from its birth to present, in a way only possible with Gran Turismo.
またですね、コースについても、車がその場所にある、その環境にある、そこにあるということがですね、素晴らしい価値になるような、世界中のですね、美しいランドスケープを、たくさん入れたいというふうに思っています。
I'm also preparing courses with beautiful landscapes, landscapes whose values will increase all the more by the presence of a car.
また実在するサーキットについても、今までのグランツリスモのシリーズではですね、積極的に実在するサーキットというのは収録してこなかったんですけれども、今回はですね、物理シミュレーションの精度が非常に上がったということで、そういったものについてもどんどん積極的に収録したいというふうに思っています。
Before, we had limited real circuits. Now, due to the enhanced accuracy of the physics engine, I look forward to including more real circuits from around the world.
そしてですね、現時点では詳しいお話できないんですけれども、ネットワークへもですね、当然対応します。現在我々はそのための作業をしているところです。
Although we cannot share with you in detail at this time, other new features include the availability of enjoying Gran Turismo online.
今回のですね、明日から始まる E3 では、SCE のブースで、Gran Turismo 4のごくごく一部ではあるんですけれども、実際に触って体験することができ できるようになっています。
All of you who are here today are welcome to experience for yourselves.A part of Gran Turismo World, starting tomorrow at the SCA booth.
最後にですね、我々のグランツリスモ4に向けての目標なんですけれども、一つはですね、グランツリスモ4が、プレイステーション2における、新しいテクノロジーのベンチマークになりたいというふうに思っています。あともう一つはですね、グランツリスモでしかできない方法で、車のライフスタイルというものをですね、どんどん追求したい。そう考えています。
In closing, my goal with Gran Turismo 4 is to set a new benchmark in technology and to further capture the automotive lifestyle.
皆さんにですね、それをお見せできる日を楽しみにしております。どうぞ期待して待っていてください。最後にもう一度ですね、今日わざわざこの時間を取っていただいて本当に感謝しております。ありがとうございました。
I'm looking forward to sharing with youthank you again once for your time.
Gran Turismo 4, ladies and gentlemen. And thank you, Kazunori. Now I'd like to talk about some hardware innovation. We talked about software content, and now it's on to hardware. Let's recap where we are today. The PlayStation 2, when it first came out in 2000, was really the first of its kind product. It fused media content, PlayStation 2 games, PlayStation games,DVD playback capability out of the box, and it also plays audio CDs for those of you who forgot. And last year, we talked about a $199 price point for the current PlayStation 2. Today, I'm happy to announce that we are extending that value proposition by releasing a new PlayStation 2 SKU. The new PlayStation 2 SKU that we will be launching in June will come bundled with the network adapter. As you all know, the network adapter is a $40 peripheral that is available separately for the PlayStation 2 users that want to go online. And we will obviously continue to offer the network adapter as a separate peripheral. But going forward, we are going to make available the network adapter right in the box of the PlayStation 2 so that all the consumers who purchase a PlayStation 2 starting from June will have out of the boxonline play capabilities right there. We're also going to be phasing in hardware that is going to take advantage and enhance some new features on the PlayStation 2, These features include the ability to play back rewritable DVD discs, plus RW, minus RW, as well as, of course, DVD-Rs. Also, it will feature progressive scan during DVD playback for higher resolution when you play back your motion pictures. It will have a built-in IR remote sensor so that the users can take advantage of the remote control without having to plug in an IR receiver in the controller port, which is the situation that we have today. And of course, not to be outdone, we heard people say that, you know what, the fan sounds a little noisy, so we've addressed that as well. The new fan is going to feature 30 decibels lower, so you can enjoy the PlayStation 2 any time of the day without waking up your family or friends, especially when you're playing at 3 in the morning. So, this extended value proposition of the PlayStation 2 with the network adapter bundled in is going to be available for $199. Again, extending the value proposition that we bring to the consumers. Other exciting news on the hardware front is, of course, the USB headset that came bundled together with SOCOM US Navy SEALs. We have now more than 1 million of these headsets in the market. And the headset can be used standalone as new games come out which feature voice over IP. And obviously, that enhances the gameplay experience even further. And we will be bringing out into the market this fall a PlayStation 2 branded USB headset so that, again, consumers can experience voice over IP with a variety of games that will be coming out later this year. Also, we have a very exciting new product that we are going to bring out, which is called iToy. Now, let me show you what the iToy looks like. This is a, if we can get a shot of this. This is the iToy camera. This is a revolutionary USB camera, very easy to use, plug and play, as is all the peripherals with PlayStation. Just plug it into the USB port of your PlayStation 2. All you need to do is really just focus, because everything else has been pre-calibrated. And this is obviously designed to really take advantage of the hardware's power and the flexibility that the PlayStation 2 brings. This allows for a variety of new entertainment experiences for the consumers and interact with the software in the PlayStation 2 without having to rely on the controller, but by being able to control the PlayStation or interact with the gameplay using this camera alone. And this technology was developed for about 2 years at the SCEA R&D facilities in Foster City. And there is a consumer product software that goes along with the iToy camera that was developed by our sister company, Sony Computer Entertainment Europe. And now, to talk a bit more about iToy and what it can do, I'd like to introduce our next guest, the inventor of the iToy technology. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Richard Marks.
How's it going?
Hi, guys.
All right.
So in order to show you iToy, I think we have one set up over here and give you an example of the iToy. You see the camera, it sits on top of a television set, and there's a PlayStation 2 down here, and there's no controller hooked up right now because the camera is going to be my interface. What you're seeing on screen is the same thing I'm seeing on my television set, and it's what a user would see. So there's, to interact with the system is very intuitive. You just reach up and move your hand in front of the buttons, and you can scroll through the mini games that we have on this disc here. I'm going to call up one of the games and get started. Call up Kung Fu. We just say select that game.
Okay, you just chose Kung Fu. Okay, all right.
So Kung Fu is a classic arcade-style game where there's a lot of bad guys that are coming after you and you have to try to fight them off. And it has a lot of the traditional gameplay elements of multiple levels, bonus rounds, and there's a big boss at the end. So this is showing me that I need to fight off the bad guys. We'll get started here. Again, all the interface is just through the camera. So this looks... show you how that works right now.
Get ready. Fight.
Fight. All right.
The interface is really flexible, and you can be creative with what you do. You
need to be in Rise to Honor.
Use your head.
Forget Jet Li.
And when you want to exit the game, you can just walk up to the camera, put your hand over the game, that exits you to the menu screen. And yes, I'm sure I want to exit. As I mentioned before, there's 12 games on the disc that comes with the camera. And there's a wide variety of games. There's rhythm action games, fighting games, a little bit of sports, some puzzle games. So I'm going to show you another game here real fast.
Wishy-washy. All right.
Wishy-washy is probably the most novel of all the games that come on the disc. It's actually a... So the idea with Wishy-washy is it's going to come up and you're not going to see me because I'm behind a dirty window. And the job I have to do is clean the dirty windows. This is great, especially for young people and people of all ages, because it's very simple what you have to do. You just have to move around and clean the windows. So the faster you do it, the more windows you clear off, the more points you get.
Now, did you bring your squeegee today, or is that not part of the package?
I'm trying. It's a bit of a workout here. Why don't you come over and help me, Kaz?
Me? No, I don't think so.
Come on.
All right. I tell you, I hate it when things are not in the script here.
Okay. You can clean off that. There we go.
All right, just stand here.
Yep, just stand there. Go ahead. I think he's better than I am. Wait a minute. We can do it together, too, which is another great thing.
All right, you take that part.
He can cover that side, I cover this side.
Is this like a new career for me, or... there we go. Very cool. Okay, why don't you come out here again? Thank you very much.
Thank you, Gus.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Richard Marks. Okay, a bit of a workout there. Okay. So, iToy Camera... It will ship with a disc with 12 game applications for a $39 SRP, and it will become available here in North America in October of this year. Now, there were we just demonstrated two very fun games, but iToy as a camera, as a peripheral, has really a lot of long-term potential. We're talking about real-time special effects, video conferencing, which we are actually showcasing at the Logitech booth at E3, a virtual pet application. Really, the list is endless. And right out of the box, by the way, we've incorporated a feature where you can tape video messages up to a minute on your memory card. And so, instead of putting sticky notes on the refrigerator, you can actually leave a note or a message for your friends and family right through iToy, through the iToy camera. So some very exciting applications with iToy. Now I'd like to move on to the third part of our four-part strategy, and that is community. Last year, when I spoke about the PlayStation 2 and moving the PlayStation 2 consumers into the online space, a lot of people asked the question, can console gaming really become a viable part, and can online become a viable part of the console gaming experience? The answer is a definite yes, as long as you have the right strategy. And the first key to success, obviously, is to make sure that you have a solid platform position, which we definitely have with the PlayStation 2. Don't try to replicate what the PC experience has been, because the consumers are playing the PlayStation 2 in the living room. And so what we have done is taken an approach where we have made online really an extension of the PlayStation 2 gaming experience in the living room. Our goals last year were really to lead the consumers online, taking a very open market approach to the consumers' choices of connectivity options, whether we're talking about broadband, dial-up, ISPs, also making it very open to our third-party publishing partners to come up with their own business models to capitalize on the PlayStation 2 online users. And we also had realistic expectations of where we thought the consumers were going as far as the online space was concerned. And the result has been nothing short of astounding. To this date, we have, just in the North American market, more than 600,000 network adapter users, and we have, in the past 6 months, built the largest online community in the gaming space, whether we're talking about console or whether we're talking about PCs. And obviously, the network adapter doesn't sell itself. The users want to go online because there's compelling content to go online. And one of that would be, of course, SOCOM US Navy SEALs. We've sold more than 1 million units just in the North American market alone. 30% of those users are enjoying the online gameplay, and we have between 50 and 60,000 people that on an average day come to play, with more than 13,000 simultaneous users playing SOCOM. Some of the things that we've found out about our users as they go online is that content really builds the community. You have to have exciting content to have people come online. Online gamers, they play more often and they play longer. And of course, when they're online competing with other people, they become more competitive. This is a demographic breakdown of the PlayStation 2 network adapter user base, with more than 73% of the users between the ages of 18 and 34. And to date, more than 98% of those users are male. So what does that mean? There's a lot of potential for additional and different kinds of applications to bring the other half of the population into the PlayStation 2 online world. I talked about the ability of the network adapter to use both broadband and dial-up. This is the breakout right now as we speak. 58% broadband, 42% is on dial-up. We made sure with the network adapters that we left no one behind, and the numbers really speak for themselves. There is a considerable number of users who want to connect through dial-up, and we made sure with the network adapter that we included them in our online plans. So what are the next steps? What we want to do is take the more than 600,000 users that we've been able to bring to the PlayStation 2 online user base and transition really from an early adopter market to more of a mainstream or a mass market proposition. And we believe that for critical mass, we want to have at least 1 million users on the PlayStation 2 online community. And once we reach critical mass, it opens up a host of different experimentation, whether it's with software content or other online content. And ultimately, we in North America expect to have between 5 to 10% of the overall PlayStation 2 installed base going online. And of course, as I mentioned earlier, with the introduction of the PlayStation 2 online pack, which bundles the network adapter with the PlayStation 2 hardware, we believe that we are making some significant strides in bringing a mass market audience into the PlayStation 2 world, online world. Some titles on online that I'd like to share with you today. SOCOM 2, US Navy SEALs. Again, SOCOM has sold more than 1 million units in North America alone, and we are coming out with a sequel with additional gameplay features in November of 2003. Siphon Filter, another first-party title that we brought out and became a huge franchise on the original PlayStation, will be coming to PlayStation 2 with online capability, including voiceover IP, taking advantage of the headset that I talked about earlier. And of course, Final Fantasy XI. We are very happy to be working very closely with Square Enix and for SCA to be able to publish Final Fantasy XI for the North American market. And together with the hard disk drive, this online-only software title will become available in the North American market in the first quarter of calendar 2004. Now, I have a very brief video to show you of Final Fantasy XI, so please take a look. Come on. Final Fantasy XI, ladies and gentlemen. Another very important genre of games as we move the PlayStation 2 experience online is sports. All the major brands of sports are on the PlayStation 2, and sports, perhaps more so than any other genre in the online space, really has the opportunity to bring community building, online tournament play, as well as real-time stats and roster updates. And so we're very excited about the prospects of this genre to expand the PlayStation 2 online experience. And in that regard, I'm very happy to announce today that EA Sports, all of their 9 online-enabled titles in the sports area will be exclusive online to PlayStation for the 2003-2004 season. Thank you. And now I'd like to introduce our next guest. He comes from a company that has shared the stage with us for the past 4 years at the E3 press conference for PlayStation, a long-standing partner of Sony Computer Entertainment, Inc. They are the largest publishing company in the world. And they're here today to share with you some of their exciting marquee titles on the online space for launch for the 2003-2004 season. So ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the President and Chief Operating Officer of Electronic Arts, Mr. John Riccitiello.
Thank you very much, Taz. On behalf of everyone at Electronic Arts, I can tell you for sure that we're proud to be back at E3. In 2003, we're back with an even bigger and better lineup of games on the PlayStation 2. And as Kaz just mentioned, the world of EA Sports will be online exclusive with the PlayStation 2. Now, last year, we offered 2 titles on PS2 Online, Madden and NBA Live. And we received an incredible response from core gamers that love sports. More than 450,000 players registered to compete in EA Sports Online on the PS2, which made ours the world's largest console online community. Nobody else came close. This year, EA Sports Online through the PS2 will include incredible new features, tournaments, ladders, cash prizes, and perhaps more important than anything else, the voiceover IP. We call it EA Sports Talk. Software that allows you to trash talk the guy you're playing with just as if they were sitting next to you on the couch. What I'd like to do now is show you some of these titles. Now, what you're not going to see is videotape. We're about to watch 6 EA Sports games played live, online, with tournaments, features including voice chat. Make that EA Sports Talk. Playing here from Los Angeles to 6 different cities around the country. Let's start with the NFL, Madden NFL 2004, the best-selling sports game worldwide. Madden's back and looks even more spectacular this year. Melvin Lindsay is here in Los Angeles to show us the game. Melvin, who are you playing against?
Phil Frazier in Orlando, Florida.
In Florida. You got him on live sports talk?
Yes, I do, right now.
You ready to take him down?
Yeah, I'm going to score. I'm going to this play right now.
Here we go. Take a look. Ooh, that looked painful. Alpha code and it still works.
Let's see if I can get a little play action play here. Maybe to score.
All right, here we go. Can we score?
Ooh. Oh, his defense is too tight.
That looks amazing. Let's give you one more play.
Yeah, that's fine. Set. There you go. Touchdown.
Congratulations. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, now we're going to leave the world of the NFL and go to NBA basketball. NBA Live 2004. Last year, NBA Live revolutionized console basketball with freestyle control. NBA Live was the number one selling basketball game on all platforms. Otis Peric is here to demo live. Who are you playing against, Otis?
I'm playing against Dan Leahy.
All right. Can you take him?
Oh, I'm taking him to school right now.
Oh, let's see what you got.
Come on, Dan, bring it. Dan's in Chicago right now.
Whoa, that looked quick.
Here's Weber.
Good work.
Let's go, Weber. Let's go.
Ooh, crossover, what do we got? To the freestyle control. Unbelievable. Okay, we're now going to leave the world of the NBA and go on to the world of sports, the world of sports racing, with an EA Sports exclusive, NASCAR Thunder 2004. Now, this is a game that was made to play online. Tom Geddes is here to demo the game for us. How's the car handling?
It's looking pretty good here.
Who are you playing against, and where are they?
I got Trevor up in San Francisco.
Up in San Francisco? Let's see what you can do. You're in the Home Depot car, right?
That's right. Tony Stewart, Winston Cup champ. Oh! Big wreck.
A little pile up. I think
just
we can pull out of that,
that
and do something
flag.
Good. Going inside. And Corey kills himself. I'm going to move on. Now, leaving NASCAR, I'm going to go on to the king of college sports, NCAA Football 2004. Now, last year, EA Sports NCAA Football was the number two selling football game in the country behind Madden, beating every other NFL game in the marketplace. Jordan Edelstein is here to show us the game. How you doing, Jordan?
I'm doing well, John.
Who are you playing with?
I'm taking on Jimmy in Austin, Texas.
In Texas. So he's in Austin?
Austin, Texas.
And you got the EA Sports talk going?
I am. I'm getting trash talk Southern style, but I'm about to... Oh,
oh that was close.
Did they have kicked a field goal there, Herbie?
Yeah, I think
so. Jimmy,
so it's
only
the
back.
First time. Get as many points as you can now because you never know how many you're going to have to score in the second half to win.
They'll take over at the 22-yard line.
All right, let's see if you can get it in. Come on.
Number five has four receivers lined up.
You got nothing.
He's looking. Rolling out to the right side.
There we go.
And an outstanding play defensively.
Hey, the defense owns this one.
And managed to get a hand in there to deflect the ball away.
It's second down and 10 to go. Ball 22.
I'm getting an earful with a Southern accent.
We need some yardage here. Live online.
They come out with four wide out. Number five drops back. Down the middle.
You know, I think we're going to give this one to the defense. Okay, we're now going to leave the gridiron and go to the world's most popular spectator sport, the EA exclusive FIFA Football 2004. Now, great news for the Europeans. This year, Sony Europe and EA Europe will provide online play for FIFA this fall. FIFA will have all the great features, all the stuff you'd expect, from tournaments and ladders to the voice chat, EA Sports Talk. Now, Matt Bilby is playing here. Matt, you are here.
I'm here.
Who are you playing with?
I'm playing Christoph in Vancouver, British Columbia.
Up in Vancouver?
He should be around. He's here.
You think you can take him?
Hi, Christoph.
It's a 0-0 game at the moment. He's got a very, very good defense. Let me see if I can break the defense and get some shots at goal.
Let's see what we can do. They're playing live online. Ooh. Whoa, score!
Sorry, no Beckham.
And we are going to leave the world of soccer on that high note and look at yet another EA Sports exclusive. Now, our next game is Tiger Woods PGA Tour 2004. Now, sales on this one have jumped pretty dramatically in the last couple of years if we've attracted new players through characters and features that no one else has got. This year's game's already getting a huge amount of buzz, and a lot of the core players are coming to us asking for early code. We have a volunteer to play with us today from Orlando, Florida. Who do we got up here?
Hey, John.
Hey, how you doing, Tiger?
I'm doing pretty good, bud. What's going on?
Well, I think we're going to see some competition. Now, Tiger, you know who you're playing against?
You know, someone told me I was playing against some trash-talking fool who looks like an idiot.
I think this guy may be here with us in Los Angeles. Let's take a look and let's meet him right now. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce golfing legend, Cedric the Entertainer. Welcome.
What's up? How you doing?
There's the man.
All right. Mr. Woods, where are you?
What an outfit. Oh, my.
This is going to be the latest, dog. Everybody want to rock this. This is Seti Ware Golf 2004, my friend. No red shirts.
Wow.
Get ready. And when I beat your butt in this, then you really, I want to take a picture of you. Me, and you got to wear this, matter of fact.
Oh, God.
These exact pants, matter of fact. I want them to be
look,
long and shorter.
But my goodness. Actually, they look like capris. You know, aren't women supposed to wear those?
What'd he say? You on tape delay. Wait a minute. I'm just getting it. Oh, that's funny. No.
Hey, guys, why don't we try to settle this on the course?
All right, now, we can do that.
Chose Pebble Beach, and you've already run through the first 17 holes. Let's see what the action's been so far.
Yep.
Woods, y'all, EA Sports. Uh-huh. In your face. That's right. It goes.
And Tiger Woods.
I'll teach you those moves, Tiger. Throw the cards,
Okay, we are back live. Tiger and Cedric are tied after 17, heading into the tee of the 18th hole at Pebble Beach. Tiger, I think you're up first.
All right.
Sweet. Even up.
Let's see what you got.
By the way, if anyone's watching, you notice that we're playing from the white tees just because of Seth's game.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Don't get too nervous. There's a lot of water splashing over there. You know, you've been off lately.
This is okay. Live. Tiger hit this shot, and it certainly looks
like it's cool.
I know how to play this game a little bit.
Whoa.
All right, Brian.
All right, Cedric, what do you think you got?
All right, give me the big dog, man.
You're slow playing me over here.
This is the man. He's playing live.
Let me see here. I'm going to go back. All right, I just want to take a look at it real quick. Hey, okay, that's swimming. I had to take my draw off.
Whoa.
Yes, sir. Look at it.
Whoa!
You didn't know I could play, did you, Tiger?
Oh, here we go.
That is looking good. All right, Tiger.
All right, now.
Coast to coast. Whoa.
All right.
Looking good. Where have we seen that before?
Like a little uphill left to right putt.
Yeah,
that's a heck of a shot.
Been out there for his morning round, I see now. Yeah, I think they got the wrong socks on me on the game that threw me off. All right.
Isn't that a buck?
No, man. I think that might go right there. Hold on. That might be the one. In the hole. I should be dancing on that one.
All right.
No, you be away.
Let me talk to my caddy, man.
Player conference.
Circle up here.
A little bit.
You may not know this, but the caddy is also the producer of the game.
Yeah,
Now, today would be great.
This is it, man. Don't worry, you.
Wow!
That's it. That's the pop and lock. That's the pop and lock. This is your chance. Don't shake, Tiger, please.
All right.
Please, don't worry about it. You know, if you don't get it in this time, you know, there is other holes.
Ladies and gentlemen, this round goes to Cedric.
All right, Ced.
All right. All right.
You're the man.
Tiger, any last words?
Hey, Ced's the man.
All right. All right, Tiger, bro. Thank you very much.
All right, guys. All right, Cedric, thanks for having me.
All right, good.
Kaz, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, EA Sports Online. It starts this July on the PlayStation 2. We'll see you there. Thanks. Yeah, beat him!
In the game.
Thank you. Thank you, Tiger. Thank you, Cedric. And thank you, John, as well, for that exciting piece of golf play. I'm not very much of a golfer, but that looked pretty exciting. Now, on to the last portion, or the last fourth point of our strategy as we evolve the business, is talking about market expansion. And I'd like to introduce our final guest speaker today to talk about our plans to expand the PlayStation experience. He's a gentleman that I always have the pleasure of introducing, you know, sitting in the audience, but today he's going to be here making a presentation. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming the President and Chief Executive Officer of Sony Computer Entertainment, Inc. worldwide, and also better known as the father of the PlayStation, Mr. Ken Kutaragi.
Thank you, sir. Hi, everyone. Thank you for sharing your valuable time with us today. You have already seen some of the great games coming out on PlayStation 2.